Hello everybody and welcome once again to Running Red, the hardcore questing mod from Gideon Seymour. Now today, the first thing I'm going to do is to make a sigil. And the sigil I want to make is this one, the sigil of elemental affinity. What this sigil does is give you protection against fire, water. It's a lava sigil, an air sigil, I think this one will be the best one to use, and a water sigil, and the demonic stone, I think. I haven't got one of those with me, and I need some obsidian and a magician's blood orb. Let's quickly go and get the rest of this stuff over here. You'll notice a little bit missing in terms of stone. Well, I've been very busy, and I'll show you that in a minute. So the obsidian around the corners, and I think it was demonic slaves. Just double check it. No, an imbued slate. Oh, no big deal. We should have some of those in this chest over here. Imbued 9, yes. And that will give me this sigil of elemental affinity, and it basically gives you protection against fire and drowning and full damage too. You can activate it with right click. So now that's activated, and it should be activated by me. And of course it's using LP from the network. And as you can see here, I've got water breathing and fire resistance because of this. If I turn that off, now it disappears. In fact, before I do what I want to do next, let's quickly charge up the jetpack. I saw it was getting a bit low. Now this thing actually will charge up very quick. I upgraded the power storage into a resonant cell, energy cell, which is somewhere here. And I also put, of course, the redstone cable energy conduit through there as well. So let's put this back on. In fact, the one I'm going to take is not that one. I'm going to take a different one. I'm going to take the one that gives me void damage, which is this one here. I'm going to put this on. I don't think I need it. We shall see. The next thing I'm going to do is also to check my network. That's the divination signal. So I'm hoping to get, yes, we've got 10 million LP. Oops, sorry, back again. Now, what I've built over here is, you'll notice here this hive has eventually changed to a rocky hive. So I've now got rocky bees. Oh, I can't fly up, can I? Air sigil I do have with me. Let's get the air sigil. I did promise to do witchery today. Well, I'm going to do that anyway. But and what this is here is a platform they built, and this is going to be the ritual of the falling tower. And this is actually quite a dangerous ritual. That's why I've got these things with me. Doesn't mean I'm going to live, but we'll try it. So first thing we're going to do is activate this with an activation crystal. Like that. Now it's a little bit of smoke. Let's put on here now the let's eat the apple first of all, and also do this, and then put the diamond in here. Let's see if we can get it on the place. Yes, oops, missed. Did I miss? Oh no, I didn't miss. Get out of here then, because there's going to be a meteor dropping from the sky, I hope. There you go, one meteor dropped on the sky. Well, made a few holes everywhere, but it succeeded. And the meteor should, look at this. Wow. And this meteor contains all sorts of things. Emerald ore, diamond ore, and amber, and other things. Let's go and have a look. Let's go and get the jetpack back on again. And in fact, where's the jetpack here? So I survived it, good. Well, dear, the only thing that did survive was that. Let's get the sigil of magnetism going as well. I think that's here. And pick up anything that's lying around. Right, some torches. And I should just double check. F7 is pressed. Yes, I thought so. There'll be plenty of mobs spawning here if I don't do this right. So let's put a few torches down wherever they're needed, and we can I will repair the deck below it. Well, look at this. It really did make quite a big bang, and for quite a large area too. This doesn't matter where I put the torches too much. But now I have a source of diamonds, and the problem I was having before is with the witchery, it's using a lot of diamonds. And in this particular ritual, there's 108 ritual stones used. So that's a lot of ritual stones. I think that's now safe. Let's have a look. So whatever. Oh yes, there's a torch on the top there as well. So amber bearing stone, diamond ore, cinnabar ore, emerald ore. This is actually really good. There's lots of it. So what I need to do now is to get myself a... I'll put a few torches down on this. I don't suppose it matters if mobs spawn too much, but who knows. Hopefully they just fall off and die. And the last one there, I think. And that should be back to sort of normal. It did actually blow up all those grass as well. Look at this. My goodness, it did make a big bang. Whoa. I'm picking up loads of stuff as well. It's interesting. Anyway, importantly, the bees are okay. In fact, I've had some success with the bees. Here now, she's got a diligent queen, which is, what's the right word for this one? It's a purebred. Are we getting some stringy comb? Stringy comb's very useful as well. This one here I got some cultivated, and what I did with this one is I crossbred it with a rocky queen, and hopefully I was hoping to get some of the properties from the rocky queen. So let's have a look at this while we're actually here. I don't think I've actually got my potion plant seeds, rain plant seeds, everything I need with me. Let's just put into here the comb, and you'll see I'm getting diligent princesses now, drones from this queen, and I'm also getting nobles here, so I've got a reasonable and dripping comb. So the bees are coming along nicely. There's also the slime farm seems to be working quite well too. I put everything away that I had, it was over here anyway. So this was actually far enough away, so the builder's wand, and the bee analyzer and the diary. This is not silky touch, this is just efficiency. So let's go and put these seeds away somewhere. I'll repair everything off screen, of course. Won't bother bothering you with that. But we do need to get rid of some of this stuff here. And the reason for this, of course, was all to do with witchery. So last time I built the witch's oven and two funnels, and this time we've got to make some more stuff. Right, let's have a look what we needed to do. What we're actually aiming to do is to build Dreamweaver of Nightmares, and this requires certain items, splash potion of poison, which we did, and we got to get some diamond vapor. Now diamond vapor is made in the distillery. So let's make the distillery next, and I think this is the distillery. So here we need an attuned stone. Now the attuned stone is a diamond, a lava bucket, and a whiff of magic. The whiff of magic is the rowan sapling in the witch's oven. So we got some of that last time, in fact got lots of it as it happens, and clay jars. So let's start with doing the attuned stone. In fact, been daft. Let's just dig up this crafting table and turn it. Oh no, it doesn't make a difference because that's not a wooden chest, that's a dark gold chest. Have I got any space in my inventory here? Oh, I've got too many bees. Let's quickly put those bees away. The only chest that's got any space in it at the moment is this one. I was going to analyze these four. I'll do that in a minute. and we've got some space. Let's just take these out of the way for the time being. And come back over here. Right, so a tune stone with a whiff of magic, a diamond and a bucket of lava. In fact, I need a couple, so let's make two. So it's a whiff of magic, diamond, and a bucket of lava gives me one, and the second one is done the same, like this. Now, so we need to make a distillery, didn't we? So let's put one of these back, because I've got it prepared. I think that goes in here. Oh, look, exactly what I was trying to do. So let's do that recipe now. So we need these and a distillery. I probably should be able to shift click this one this time, which I can, so I get one distillery. Actually, let's turn this one off now. I don't need the magnetism on. And where should we put the distillery? Let's put this distillery here. I don't think it matters where we put it, to be honest with you, at the moment. We're going to have to make a few things for this as well. Now, in the distillery, we need some... What did we need to do? Let's come back here. We need some bottles. So we've got plenty of bottles, clay jars. Let's put some bottles in here first of all. I'm just wondering if I could hear a mobs. No big deal if I can, I'll find it. I'm well protected at the moment. So we wanted to do this one. So we needed this diamond vapor. So to do that we needed some quicklime, some foul fume. Now foul fume is very easy. You just put in the oven wood and you'll get some foul fuel. Fumes out of there. So I've got plenty of that, so we need some. Let's go back with backspace. And quicklime is made with wood ash, which was also a byproduct of the witchery process. So let's make this one first of all. When do we get this oil of vitriol? I think that's how it's pronounced. I have difficulty with these things. So what do we want? We wanted two foul fumes. Let's just do two of these and one bottle. In fact, I don't need the bottle, that was just for the recipe. So two foul fumes, two quick lamps, and should start processing if I've got this the right way around. What does it say here? Maybe I've got this the wrong way around. Nope. No entry, what does that mean? This could require a bit more work. I think this is actually powered by it's powered by the witch's altar, or at least some. I think it's powered by the witch's altar. So the next thing I'm going to have to do is to make a witch's altar. Right, I'm going to have to come back and do that at another time, because it requires a lot of stuff to do. Okay, so we're a bit stuck on that one at the time being. So what else can we do on this particular one? Right, so we can't do that until we get power for this distillery. I knew there was something, but it's obviously not redstone. Feathers, no problem. Item frames, no problem. Tormented twine's going to be a problem, because it requires disturbed cotton, and you only get disturbed cotton by dreaming. So we actually need a brew, and I suspect I can't make the brew either. Oh, maybe I can actually. It's a brew of sleeping we need. Right, and I think it's the brew of sleeping witchery. Blue sprouting, blue substitution, this one. So we make that with some purified milk, some whiff of magic, icy needle, and a water artichoke globe. The brew of love and a cookie. Right, cookies no problem. Let's have a look. Purified milk is craftless shaping, three buckets, one bucket of milk, and one odor of purity. An odor of purity is a hawthorn sapling, so we need to get some hawthorn saplings. In fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create another ritual of the green growth, because that really does accelerate things incredibly. So wrong chest. So we need one master ritual stone, and we need I think it's only eight of these actually ritual stones. So let's get my ritual diviner out again, now that I actually know what it's called. So that was the mark of the falling tower. So let's just shift right click until we find call of the Zephyr. I would like to do as well ritual of, here we go, ritual of the green growth. What I'm going to do, and I'm going to come over to this corner here, I think it'll be a good place. Now it's only a block, it's only a block that's 9x9, so it's no big deal. Let's just chop this lot, dig this lot up here, and I should have the pickaxe here. That's where I want to put the master ritual stone. So let's just drop down and pick up those things, and we simply dig away these here. So we just need an 8, as simple as that. So now we'll put the dirt back up the top here. I do actually have one dirt from the other explosion, and we'll put the master ritual stone in the middle like that, and then we'll simply right click this until I'll do it. So put these 8 ritual stones beside me, and you can see them actually disappearing every time you click. Okay, so that's water, and which is that one, the green one's earth, I think. So all we need to do is activate this, so we can right click this with the, it doesn't matter whether it's awakened or weak, and that should now be on. In fact, in this particular case you can use a switch. If the switch is on, it turns it off. I just picked up something else then. So now we have this area growing like crazy. So what I want to do in here is I want to put a hawthorn sapling. And have I got one? I've got plenty of hawthorn trees. These are hawthorn trees. Let's get this one. And if I use the crook, I'm bound to get one or two saplings straight away. Yes, there's the one. There's two. There's another one. What may happen is I also might get another witchery item called an elk, I think it is. Which is actually a mob. Let's have a look how many we got. 5. Well, that'll do for now. So, I can't get out. I've stuck myself into these things here. So let's come back to the planter, and so I want the top right, which is the green side. So I'm going to put into the green side here these here, and take out a stack of seeds, and hopefully we shall get some trees planted in the right place, which looks like it's going to happen. And of course what I have forgotten to do is to allow these to come back in again. Let's just take this one away. Let's come over to the filter over here, which of course is now blocked with seeds, but that doesn't matter. There's a zombie. I thought I'd dealt with all of those guys. An angry zombie. Yeah. A dead angry zombie. Oh, you see, I've got some water artichoke globes. And those are coming from the seeds, the water artichoke seeds, which are actually in the harvest range. I'll have to go and find out where that zombie came from in a minute. We'll just finish this first of all. So I need an empty hand, I think, to see this. Yes. So the one I wanted to allow in here now is a hawthorn sampling. And I can put this hawthorn sampling in, and it should disappear. Oh, this is just another tree has been chopped down. So where did that thing come from? Oh yes, look, an area I completely missed. Right. In fact, I've still got my water breathing and fire resistance on. Is that because of this sigil? Or maybe it's just because... Did I activate this sigil? I did. That's better. I don't like all those particle effects anyway. They drive you bonkers. Yes, it's working nicely. Oh, look. What on the earth was that I just picked up? Oh, zombie rain from the killing that zombie, huh? And in here, in these little pools, which I thought I'd got here, I'd put some water artichokes in. That's where the... Oh, look. Yes, I'm going to have to do a bit of repair work. So I'll put a few more in here, because these are obviously not getting harvested when they come back in again. And that's the planter. Maybe I can put one in the planter as well. You see how it has done a lot of holes from that explosion. But at least I've got what I needed. Hopefully we have anyway. So that was rather interesting today. The one I wanted to do was also the call of the Zephyr. But I don't think I'm going to have... Well, I've got time. Now, I need another ritual stone. Let's do that first of all. So... Now I want the master ritual stone, don't I? So it is the magician's up to... orb I do need, so what's the one I've got? Ritual stones, I need 4, which I haven't got with me. Fact, I've got too much junk on me at the moment. I'm going to have to clear this out. Oh, look at that. It's gone and harvested all those trees as well, because they're in the quite near to the harvester range. Let's put the glowed artichokes up here. And seeds we can put over there. And a rose. We do actually need a rose, I think, at some stage. And the mob droppings will just get rid of, if I get round past that. So we got some of those. Actually, I'll put that in as well. I don't need that for the time being. This is the one I wanted to get rid of. Quick sort. That's all. And then we can put the seeds in the squeezer. Huge squeezer. Let those get right. We've got this attune stone, haven't we? Oh my goodness, look at all that. It's actually chopped down my big tree as well. Didn't really want it to do that. It really did get carried away doing this. These hawthorn trees, look at that. I didn't pick them all up. So I'm left with one hive in the middle of nowhere and lots of mushrooms, which I've got to chop up, of course, because they won't survive. Or roses I don't need to chop up. But mushrooms I do. Oh. As you'll see, I actually extended the base a lot. Using the builder's wand, very easy. All you have to do with the builder's wand is simply point at something. See, I've got 64 and 19. So I just point at this here and it'll do a row of 9 at a time. So you can just go around here doing extending the thing out by a row of 9. And now what's the intention is to extend this garden out a bit, which I'll do in my own time, of course. See, that even extended that up. But of course, now we get a chance of mob spawning. So let's just put one there and one here. Right, I think that was all. Amazing it chopped down all those trees, can't believe it. Because everything that was in there is now coming to this chest here, and its chest is now full. Fantastic. Rowan wood, oak wood, birch wood, what else have we got in here? fact, it's so full I can't do anything. What I'll do is I'll just sort out these as well. I stack these normally. And I can't even carry what I've got here. That's amazing. Oh, two apples. We can take the apples out of there. And hopefully we'll get some interesting things. I've got some jungle saplings. So somehow or other, these jungle saplings are getting analysed as well. So these are the oak saplings. Don't ask me why. Because I don't have a tree analyzer on me. Anyway. So my inventory is even fuller than it was just a second ago. Which is... I've got in this chest, yes. Armor. Probably don't need that. So we can put some saplings in here, can't we? And the wood we can go and put actually in here too, if we can get it in. The mushrooms go in this chest. And there should be space for in mushrooms and in here too. And apples. That's a bit better. So I needed some obsidian and some ritual stones. Let's take the ritual stones that we've got, which is blood runes 28. We only need 16 for the one I want to do, which is a call of the Zephyr. But let me just check what I've got in here. Still anything interesting? Yes, I need that. Probably don't need the scoop, but I'll take it with me anyway. And we've got some arrows. We'll take the arrows because we never know. I haven't got the infinite enchant yet. But I've got plenty of XP though. What did I want? A master ritual stone, so I need some obsidian. I need 4 obsidian. So I think the obsidian goes like this. Right, now let's go back and get the ritual diviner. So the one I want to do is the call of the Zephyr, but I'm not going to do it here. I'm going to do that in the Nether. If I can find it, there we go. And if I now look at this, it'll tell me what I need. So I basically just need 12 air stones, which is plenty. We've got more than enough. We've got 28 or something. No, 20, I think. 24. And I'm going to take with me as well one of these. And I'm going to also take with me some slabs of stone slabs. That should be enough. 6 more here. What I'm going to do, I'm going to go to the Nether. Maybe I have to kill that slime before he gets me. Oh, there he is. Even then he managed a way to get over here. Isn't that amazing? We can kick rid of those. Right. I don't want the slime balls at the moment. I've got so many. Oops, I forgot. That's it. Forgot to turn off my thing. I thought this would be full. Only one skeleton skull. That's so great. Let's just take out a few of these blades and throw them away. Steel blade. So stone. Sort that out. That's everything, I think. It'll give me a little bit more space for a little bit more, so we just do another 3, I think. We'll see what we get. In fact, I can do 4, can't I? No point in taking the wither skill, the turn skill with me. Right. Now we simply fly over to here. I've actually got a little bit here, which is where I'm going to do this ritual. it's around about the right sort of place. It could be better if it was a bit more in the middle. But no, never mind, we can make it go towards the middle a bit more. So what we're going to do is we're going to take our builder's wand here and just quickly go towards the edge and make it a little bit bigger in this direction. Like 9x9 would probably be quite sensible. How many have we got so far? Like that. And what this is going to do, let's take this off the way. Let's put the master ritual stone down. I think I will put down one slab in the middle here. Have something to sit on, and then let's start hitting this thing with the ritual diviner, and we'll see how, what we need. It was 12, wasn't it? So I might be in the way, of course, so I have to get out of the way. There's one. Oops. Right, is that 12? I think that's it. I don't think there's any more. Let's activate this. Oh, I didn't bring something with me. That was... is this activated? Oh, does it need to be one higher? Might need to be. Because it's not activated by the looks of it. And it's not used up enough stones. So we have to dig it up a bit. Let's take the air suit light and let's turn this one on and dig. What I need is a chest. What it will do, well, at least what I hope it'll do, quite a lot of these rituals go down one block. So if we put a block of dirt on here like this and then put the master ritual stone on the dirt like this, and then start hitting it. Oops! That was a bit dangerous. And straight on me, didn't it? Yes, exactly. You'll see now it's put them below as well. Okay, good. So let's go up, and this time I should be able to activate this. What I need is a chest. See, now it's activated. So let's quickly go and get a chest. I think there's one over here anyway, so whether there's a spare one here or not, I don't know, but if there isn't, we'll take the one that we've got. We'll go back and get one quickly. No. Okay. Oh, sorry about this. I completely forgot I needed a chest. I think the switch is here. Just turn off the jetpack. Did I just pick up slime balls? Okay. So one chest. But what we'll do is we won't mess around. We'll do straightforward a gold chest. I'm not going to do a diamond chest yet because I don't have enough diamonds until I've sorted that out, and a gold. That's a good thing that I turn off that again. Oh, I didn't turn it off. There we are. So I need to go over here and just collect, put this chest on top of here. Two zombie pigmen. Well, maybe you have to say goodbye to these zombie pigmen if they're not going to be a pain. Oh, there we go. So the chest is now empty. And we will actually put down some torches so that they don't spawn too much. Let's press F7, make sure it's pressed. I thought it was pressed already, but you can't see anyway. Okay, so if I now kill something, let's see, let's take this blaze over here. What we got down there? Oops, oh, it's a ghast. Ooh, let's go and get the ghast, because we never know with the ghast. Might get ghast here. If I can get him, that is. I'm having difficulty getting to him. Usually kills himself when I get this close. Here we go. Because I've got the magnetism on, we've probably got a gas tier, two gas tiers, fantastic. Okay. So, where are we now? I want to kill these blazes and see if I get the blaze rods picked up in the chest. That's the intention anyway. I've never done this before, so I don't even know it's going to work. That's that skeleton. Oh, that's a zombie pigman. That's another skeleton. Oh, he died. Oh, we got one torch. That's very clever. Where did that torch come from? It came from here, didn't it? Now, why has it come off there? Okay. Probably because of the gas. So we got some magnets here. Let's have a look. I'm hoping it'll do it. So it's only a test. I think quite like killing those magnets. That's surprising. We can attract some mobs to us. Where's that one shooting me from? Out there. Too low. There he goes. Well, I see stuff falling down, but I'm not sure that a 21 by 21 zone is going to be big enough, so I did get a blaze rod. So it does sort of work. Try again. Yes, got him. Of course, I ain't going to end up pushing these guys off, so. Oops, like that. He's got a boat. There's definitely a skeleton. Oh, he's shooting back. Can't have that. I missed him. Didn't that time, though. There's a wither. He didn't see me, didn't react at all, just how many arms have to hit him? That's three. Oops, just aggravated the zombies. Nah, doesn't seem to be working too well. Never mind. It was just a try. Since I've aggravated the zombie pigman, let's just get rid of this one. Let's see if we did actually pick anything else up in here. No, just the one. Blaze rod, we'll take that with us. Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed this episode. I've run out of time again, 40 minutes. And I will see you next time. And in that time, I'm going to try and complete more of the quests for the witchery stuff, but it looks like I've got to build an altar, so I'll prepare the stuff for that and also get the altar powered. So until next time, bye for now.